Continuing where we left off in the previous episode, we will now define the destination that includes the domain of our API so that the app router can call it on our behalf. For that, we install a UI5 middleware that mocks Cloud Foundry destinations locally. We also add a UI5 section to our package.json and add the middleware as a dependency. In our UI5 YAML, we can configure the custom middleware, point it to our XSF.json file for routing, and define our destination. We can now restart our app and see the data from the YouTube API being displayed in our list. Because we will deploy our app to the Cloud Foundry environment on the SAP Business Technology Platform, we can already start preparing that. We add a package.json file to our app router, as it will be a Node.js-based application running on Cloud Foundry. The app router has just one dependency, and the start script points to that dependency. Running in Cloud Foundry, the app router will connect to the destination service to call the destination instead of using the local UI5 middleware. This is why we need a new configuration file for our destination on root level of our project. On subaccount level, we define a destination and add a few other parameters that the destination service requires. This information will be pushed to Cloud Foundry after the build during deploy time of our app. Before we close today's episode, let's simplify our app a little. First of all, we can delete our local data.json file, as we are now using the remote source instead. Also, instead of starting our app from the index.js file, which is basically only placing our component into the DOM, we're gonna do that directly inside our index.html file. We edit the onInit attribute in our bootstrapping and insert a div for our component inside our HTML body. We can now delete our index.js file, which is no longer needed. Let's continue in the next episode.